you some basic questions, Ryan. So firstly, tell us a bit about yourself.
Alright, awesome. So my name's Ryan, obviously. I'm 24. I've been working in the industry for 6 years now. I've been training for about 10 this year. So I've been working with elite sports originally, working in junior development teams in rugby league, rugby union, and then been working in general pop for the last about 4 years.
I find that people often think the fitness industry is all a bit of fun and games. You know, we go up for brunch, all it is chats, but it's a bit more than that, isn't it?
Yep.
So did you have a coach? Do you have a coach?
Yep. So I've definitely had coaches in the past. I'm currently not being coached mainly because work's been just like flat out for the last 6 months. But my original coach was in, his background was in powerlifting. His name was Asher. I got coached by him pretty much every day for 4 years. And then I moved to Olympic weightlifting. I got coached by a guy called Ivan Katz and Daniel Katz for about a year and a half. And then I got coached by Ben Can, who works out of this gym, for about, I'd say, a year and a half. But then just recently, I've just been coaching myself.
Yeah, so you've been around some really successful people, that's for sure.
Yeah, some good coaches I've been lucky to like learn off and sort of adapt their styles into my coaching as I've gone along.
Yeah, as you do. And what are some of the qualities that you look for in a coach? Like, what if I was a girl looking for a coach,
yeah,
you know, what sort of questions would I be asking?
Yeah, definitely. I guess the first thing is you need someone that's passionate, committed, and accountable. So accountability is basically the most important principle with fitness. So someone that's going to keep you on track. And then beyond that, you need someone that's willing to go the extra mile to continually educate themselves. People that are going to courses, reading books, like, often, like, it's important to just keep absorbing information because the information and recommendations about training and nutrition just change so quickly.
So being in my 14th week with you now, Ryan, you know, broadly speaking, how long do you think it takes to see results, get results?
Yeah, definitely. And I guess results are definitely context dependent. So whether you're trying to gain muscle or lose fat, those two different recommendations and guidelines are going to change pretty dramatically. So in your case, when you're trying to lean out, I would generally say 0.5% to 1% of body weight loss per week is a good target. And then of that 1% or 0.5% of body weight that you lose, if you're maintaining adequate sleep, protein intake, reducing your stress, and obviously training a lot, so giving yourself that stimulus, you can be sure that you're maintaining the most amount of muscle possible, if not growing a touch, meaning that most of that weight that's coming off will be fat mass. And if you're trying to add muscle, then I'd say probably about 0.25% to 0.5% of your body weight increase per week is a good sort of target to aim for.
I'm absolutely loving my program. It's been such a fun journey and I'm just learning an absolute shitload, let's be honest. But in the scheme of things, what do you see moving forward with my program?
Yeah, definitely. So with Brie's training, so what we've done accumulation blocks for the last two training cycles. So basically where we're trying to lift more, do more sets week to week. The next training phase that you're going into is going to be more of a strength intensification phase where we're going to be pushing what you're capable of in terms of weight wise. So it's going to be a bit of a strength focus.
Yeah, totally. That's awesome. And how often do you think about changing up your training program? Because you know you don't want to stay the same and be plateauing. You know?
Yeah, definitely. And for most people and coaches that sort of I've talked to, 4 weeks is a good training mesocycle. Personally though, with my coaching, I like to do 6 weeks just because you can use that first week to get adjusted to a new program, which if you're a new client is often beneficial, and it also serves as a mini deload. So you're going to do the least amount of volume in that first week so you can recover from training, hopefully.
Yeah, awesome. All about it. I have a couple of questions for you.
Definitely. Hit me with
them. Peanut butter or Nutella?
Peanut butter.
Oh!
Yeah.
AM sessions or PM sessions?
I'm a big fan of PM training. People that train at 6 a.m. are psychos, or 4 a.m.
Not a psycho. Favourite macro-friendly snack?
Macro-friendly snack, peckish rice crackers.
Oh, that's a good question.
Definitely, dip? Yep, dip, avocado. Yeah.
Weird. Podcast or books?
Definitely books. Massive fan of eating.
Nerd. Alright, well that's it from me, Ryan. But have you got anything else you want to touch on?
No. Just with any of your training, just make sure you research it out, make sure you're going with someone credible, like Indy or someone that's keeping up to date with the current science, and yeah, just make sure you stay accountable.
Yeah, totally. Well, thanks so much for chatting. It's been so much fun. Looking forward to the next 14 weeks to see what we